afternoon and welcome to Audio Tree Live for this stunning October Sunday, the 20th, 2013. Thanks to Emperor Cabs, The Music Garage, and Demos Pizza, we're honored to have the incredible Kevin Devine and the goddamn band.
Oh, wow. Thank you.
Welcome. Incredible. You're welcome.
Yeah. Just because of the Thunderstruck thing, that was really
it was really great. Yeah. Take it away, guys.
All right, this song is called Private First Class. Private Manning standing in a courtroom, pleading guilty, she shouldn't have to. The truth be told, she'd be floating down parade routes. The truth was told, and what good did that do? But if it was you, you might wish you'd been born a liar. You might wish you'd been born a liar. You might wish you'd been born a liar. A liar, a coward. Auntie barked as she watched her Apache. Cowboy kills civilian Iraqi. The left rolled the tanks over bodies. Thought, what if everyone could see what I've seen? But if it was you, you might wish you'd been born a liar. You might wish you'd been born a liar. You might wish you'd been born a liar. A liar, a coward. Now once in a hole, years in a cage, but having a soul, married the name. Now once in a hole, years in a cage, but having a soul, married the name.
Goddamn band. Sorry, I cut you off right before you were going to speak.
No, man, we're on your thing. I should.
No, you're cool.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Thanks a ton for coming out, you know?
My pleasure. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Sweet. So you guys are on the road all the time. As a kid, my family like would always go down to Georgia, where my grandparents are from, and drive like forever. And when you drive for many, many hours, you know, like you get sleepy. And we used to do this thing called Operation Desert Storm, where in the winter, you roll down the windows, make it super cold, and then roll them up, then make it super hot. And it's the only way to, like, keep your internal temperature from, like, making you fall asleep. Wow. Do you guys have techniques that are similar
I've
to that?
I've never heard that one before.
It's really, it works really well.
We're going to have to try that one.
Yeah. It's terrible in the hot, like, time when you're sweating, but when the cold time comes, it's
then
acceptable.
It's really nice.
Yeah, it's like really relieving.
I think that I've never tried the Operation Desert Storm, but the 2006 and 7, there was a thing going on with Black Ice, which is like a trucker's weed that we definitely don't take it. It's not good. I stopped taking it because it made me feel like I was dying.
Did you say
inside.
Trucker speed?
I think so. It's like legal, but it shouldn't be.
Okay, I see.
There's a drawing of a wolf on the pack.
Also yellow jackets too, I think. Yeah. Like another.
Yeah. Wait, what did you say? There's a wolf? There's a
wolf
howling wolf?
A howling wolf on the packet of Black Ice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now it's pretty strict caffeine sometimes, but also I think drinking water actually keeps you awake better than drinking coffee does over those overnight drives.
Yeah, for sure. Because you'll crash after you have the coffee. Is black ice, does it smell like that air freshener?
It's so toxic and bad. Okay. It's so toxic.
It gets
and
dark.
Bad. What'd you say?
It gets dark.
It gets
dark, yeah.
A guy who was playing with us at the time took it too many times in a row for like five straight overnight drives. We were actually
and lost his memory.
He almost lost his life, I think. Oh, he was like green in the backstage at a club in San Francisco. Oh. And the guy was like, "What's with your friend?" They thought he was like on heroin. I was like, "No, that's something you can buy in the store."
It's right next to the 5-hour energy of Black Ice. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you guys go into your next set? Thanks again for coming out.
The song is called Little Bulldozer. Songs are on we put out a record this week called Bubblegum, and we also put out a record this week called Bulldozer. That one's on, the last one's on Bulldozer. This one's on Bubblegum. I'm sick of words. What do they say?
Yeah.
Kevin Devine and the goddamn band, Audio Tree Live.
Thank you.
Yeah, man. Kevin, Mike, Harrison, and Ben hanging out with us here in the studio.
That's right.
That's true.
As on tour, like a lot of things are scheduled out for you, as I know by talking to Harrison at 10:30 last night when I confusedly sent the wrong rider to him. So, how do you find time for sort of like free will, like making choices of your own, and what do you do in those times when it's not just like, you know, you're going from here at 3:30 to here at 4:30, and what do you do in those times, and
I'll answer first, and then I'll pass it along. I think you have to make time for it. I think for me anyway, for mental health reasons,
sure,
there has to be like time broken out where you're like not, and even if you love, and I do love everyone we tour with,
yeah,
it's a strange situation to live with five other adult people in such close proximity all the time.
Yeah.
And you need to have some time that's like, not, if I was at home, I wouldn't be going out 7 nights a week.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be like hanging out with 6 people 24 hours a day.
Sure.
So you need to like keep some of that with you. And for me, it's less about like activities.
Yeah.
And giving over to the fact that I'm probably not going to, it's not like I'm a tourist. I'm actually like, it's amazing to get to do this, but also it is like the world's coolest profession.
Sure.
So like, I have to make sure that's the priority, and I got to like take time to get away for a minute and like just kind of sort of do nothing.
Yeah.
Clear your head a little bit. But I have to like make that a priority. Otherwise,
okay,
it's easy to fall into the like slipstream of it.
Yeah. So just always going out or like always hanging out, like you're saying.
You have to be in this hive mind the whole time.
Yeah. Anybody else have insight on that?
No.
I mean, no, it's that. I mean, it's just usually you're just trying to find time to be alone more than anything because you're around someone all the time.
Yeah.
And so it's nice to, even if it's your bunk, to just climb in and turn your phone off and talk to anyone and stare at a wall.
Sure. Yeah. Stare it's at like a black really wall.
Lots of staring.
Stare at black eyes.
Yeah. Yeah. You stare. You don't take it, though. You just stare at it.
You want to stare at the wolf. Yeah,
howling.
Staring at the wolf.
Great. All right. Why don't you guys go into your next song?
Okay. This is a song that is called Bubblegum. Right? That's what the song is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dug his shoulder into mine to see if I was there. Constellated candles trapped a ghost in Union Square. A sea of street novenas, we had names for everyone. That one's gay. Sure. To let it
Kevin Devine and the goddamn band on Audio Tree Live. Kevin, could you elaborate a little bit on the difference between, or if there is a difference between your inspiration or the songwriting process between like a solo record, like a Kevin Devine record, and then specifically, I suppose, Bubblegum as like the band. Is there a difference, and like how do you?
I think that in specific with Bubblegum, Mike and I have been touring together for the better part of like 7 years.
Okay.
Pretty consistently.
Cool.
And the drummer on that record who wrote the record with us is this guy, Mike Fatum. And at the time we were making the record, we had been on tour together, the three of us, for most of 4 years.
Cool.
And the idea was to kind of encapsulate that. That band as a live animal had become much spikier, kind of noisier. Even the older songs that weren't necessarily that way kind of ended up sounding
evolved that way.
A little more Pixies-ish or something.
Okay.
And so we kind of wanted to make a record to honor that group and mm-hmm. that thing. And then at the time we finished recording and everything and started talking about touring, Mike had some opportunities that were really, he couldn't turn down in another part of his life at home professionally.
Sure.
And we like, that's great and good. And luckily we have another excellent friend in Ben who's like plays in Bad Books.
Woo-hoo,
and he's played in the goddamn band before too. So
cool.
And like he was able and willing to do this and he's killing it. So that was really lucky. But that was the point with that record. I think in terms of songwriting, there's a lot of times I write pretty much everything on an acoustic guitar, but sometimes you just hear something and you know it's one way. And to me, I know now more or less like, oh, this is something for this.
Okay.
And this is something for that.
Right.
Now, what's happening more often is like the Bulldozer stuff I thought was going to end up being like really spare, like Nebraska or something.
Okay.
And Rob Schnaff, who made that record, didn't hear it that way.
Yeah.
And so I was worried that record was going to like encroach on Bubblegum.
Okay.
But I actually think instead of coming towards it, they just kind of went in these weird directions.
Cool.
There's like more instrumentation on Bulldozer, but I don't think they sound the same at all. So that's lucky.
Yeah, absolutely.
It comes with working with different people too. I'm not the only like brain in the room.
Sure.
So people do bring different things to stuff too.
Yeah, and with collaboration, you're bound to like end up somewhere where you didn't start.
Every single time.
Yeah.
Literally every single time.
Cool.
Yeah.
Do you find that one is more fun? Is that a stupid question? Do you find that one is like more enjoyable than the other?
I think they're enjoyable for different reasons. I definitely think this record and this music, performing it live.
Yeah.
We've talked about this in the rehearsals a lot. It feels like, when I was 15 or 14, I saw Superchunk play at Lollapalooza. I'd never heard them before. I didn't know anything about them. And I remember being like, oh my God, that's the music. I want to be in that band.
Yeah.
I wanted to literally be in their band. You know?
You auditioned.
And I think, like, I remember that's a different story. I threw cassette tapes of our first band's demos at Sonic
Sweet.
Youth and Pavement on stage at that. And then later I'm like, what did I think they were going to do? Like, fucking put it on in their bus and be like, we gotta find this kid. They're probably just like, what jerk off threw these things at me?
Why is someone throwing garbage?
Yeah,
at
exactly.
Me?
But I think playing this music is incredibly fun live. It's really, there's an energy and a thrust, and it's almost like athletic in
cool.
a weird way.
Yeah.
I also really like seeing something when it's excellent, where someone just is playing an acoustic guitar in a room too. And I think there's something really equally visceral about that if it's done the right way.
Cool.
But I think I'm lucky to have both, and this is the most fun music to play with a band,
yeah.
for sure.
Yeah. Right. Cool. Well, thanks again, guys, for
oh
coming
my God.
Out.
Thank you. Thank
yeah,
you.
Absolutely. And why don't you take it away?
Sure. This last song is called Redbird.
Daydream dying. Cover corner, jigsaw mind, black side, floodlights, halls of hornets, miles.
Kevin Devine and the goddamn band, Audio Tree Live. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You very guys. Quick. Mike Stramberg, Ben Hamola, Harrison Hudson.
Absolutely. Thanks, guys. Yeah, a ton. Tonight at 6:30, or I believe doors, or maybe the show start at the bottom
doors
lounge.
Doors at 6:30.
Okay, so the very own Harrison Hudson will be playing
right.
a set, and then Now, and then these guys.
That's right.
So come out, check it out. And Hidden Hospitals.
That's right.
Says over.
That's right. That's
cool.
Right.
And Hidden Hospitals. Bulldozer and Bubblegum are out now, so check them out. Thanks to Emperor, to the Music Garage, to Demo's Pizza, to the band, everyone in the studio, awesome sound engineers helping out.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Camera folk, everybody. And viewers, if you enjoyed today's performance, be sure to support the band by getting a session at audiotree.tv and send a shout via social media to connect with us or the band. From all of us here at the Audio Tree Studios, thanks for tuning in. Goodbye.
Woo-hoo! That was great, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, awesome. That was awesome.